Right now I'm in Cadeado, in a small town called Bisil. So the town is behind me. In the town and the surrounding areas is around 9,000 people. And in the town you see people have started moving in that is not within. It's a Maasai district. People who are not Maasais, they live here to do business. And a few Maasais do it too. But then you have a lot of Bomas, a lot of Maasai Bomas surrounding this place. And right now, it's a bit green because we are in the raining season. It's an open land where you see some bushes and grass because of all the cattle now. And you also find some small scattered trees. And it's also common to see around us. We have a few mountains there behind the town, surrounding places. So I'm here to do some research, and I want to show you some trees. So let us show you some trees. This tree is called Oltepesi, and it's a few months old. It's a tree that grows naturally here, indigenous tree, and it grows very quick. It's a tree with thorns to protect itself from the animals, so they will not eat the leaves. And it has a grayish, somehow grayish bark. It doesn't grow very straight. And this one is around 25 to 30 years old. And it's around 50 centimeters in diameter. When you go up to see the top of it, it forms a nice canopy. It's around 10 to 12 meters high. And you'll see that this tree grows quite big and quite fast for being an arid tree. This tree produces fruits. The fruit starts growing in June, July, and they're now becoming mature in August. And what happens when they are mature, they drops down to the floor, to the ground. And the local people, they like going and picking them and eating them. And even it's something that the goats really like. All the wild animals, they like this fruit. And it's something very healthy to eat and nice. So it produces a lot of fruits, and that is the way it now spreads the seeds towards other areas. It has medicinal use and importance for the Maasai culture. And you see this bark, where there has been a bleeding. This bark is darker and has attached that bleeding. And what you do is, if you have problems in your mouth, you have a wound, you take a piece of it and you chew it, and then you spit, and it will heal that wound within 2 days. For the same medicine, you can also use the roots. So this is the roots of Oltepesi, and it has been cut by the local people for its medicinal purpose. And commonly with actually all the trees is that the roots, they are often more stronger and have the same medicinal purpose as the bark of the branches. You can see that the trunk is damaged, the bark is removed on many places. So the local people, the Maasais, they have been cutting the trunk mostly for its medicinal purpose. And you see, what I was talking about was this thing where the liquid has now gone into the wood or the bark. It's now medicinal. But you can also remove the dry bark. And it's something that you can use now when you lit a fire, when you start the fire. It will burn very well. Very common use for the tree is to burn charcoal. So the Maasais, they really like this tree for charcoal, because the charcoal, it burns very long, long time in the jika. And you can see, you can either cut the whole tree down and produce the charcoal from the trunk, or you can also prune it and just cut branches of it, like this one. This one is probably cut to make charcoal.